I know many people who think they're bad because they experience a lot of temptation. But today's gospel, which on this first Sunday of Lent is always about the temptations of Jesus in the desert, should be a good antidote to that kind of thinking. Hello, I'm Father James Kubicki of the Apostleship of Prayer with a little reflection about the temptations of Jesus. Most people don't think Jesus was really tempted, even though three of the four gospels say that Satan tempted Jesus. They think, okay, it's in the gospel, but he just couldn't have been tempted the way I am. And yet, listen to what the letter to the Hebrews says about this. Quote, "For we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but one who has similarly been tested in every way, yet without sin." Did you catch that? He was tested or tempted in every way that we are, and so he can sympathize with our weakness, our struggle. I guess we tend to think that Jesus couldn't really be tempted the way we are because he was holy and without sin. We tend to equate temptation with sinfulness. What Jesus shows us is just the opposite. Jesus was tempted because he was good and holy and on the path of doing the Father's will perfectly. Satan wanted to distract Jesus from his goal and knock him off that path that leads to the Father's right hand. And that's what he does with us as well. It's not so much because we're sinful, but because we're good that we are tempted. So don't get discouraged and don't give up in the face of temptations. With Jesus, you have the power to fight them and stay on the right track.